I met a lot of people through skateboarding. I made more friends in San Francisco through skateboarding than through any job I had or like any school or whatever. Like that's how I met most of the kids I know. Head, like that whole wave of 80s skateboard graphic art definitely like got me into drawing more. Mark Gonzalez, like that whole thing. So it's cool for me to still be able to do skateboard graphics because I feel like I can give back to a community that like totally built up what I'm into. His name is Scott Bourne. Scott got offered an opportunity to do a company with our distributor, and he really wanted to do it, but he said the only way he would do it is if his partner was somebody who could handle the art and the ads and all that stuff, because you know, it makes it consistent, keeps the company having a standard look that, you know, goes consistently through all their ads. So they got a hold of me, and he and I connected and worked it out. It's called the Unbelievers. I think it's something different. The majority of skateboard companies out there are definitely now, they're like, it's all image-based, like, they're projecting these guys and their cars and how much money they make, and they're turning it into every other mainstream sport and how it revolves around becoming wealthy and getting rich and famous as opposed to, like, the love of the sport and, like, what kind of people it used to attract. Our whole deal is to pitch, like, a somewhat more intelligent company that gives you back more than just a bunch of image and, like, how cool we are kind of thing. Everyone's coming from different directions, but they're all way down to project what it is they're into and not just the way they look or, you know, the way the company makes them look. It's like they're very interested in letting people know, hey, this is who I am and this is what I'm about. Based on a lot of literary reference, film reference, music. Silly Pink Bunnies is a gang, if I were to put it into one quick sentence. It's like any other skate gang. It's pseudo-intellectuals, scumbags, losers, skateboarders, derelicts, like whatever. It's all people I've met through my travels and like friends have met and friends of friends. And it started out like anything else. It was like a small town gang. Like when I was in high school, that was like our thing, you know. When I first moved to San Francisco, I knew no one. And I had like no friends, and I went to the Art Institute, and the Art Institute was really prestigious, and I felt really ganged up on, and you had to come up with these things to use for project ideas and whatever. So I would use this thing, which I pitched as like my humongous nationwide gang, which at the time was pretty much me and 8 friends. And I've stuck little bits of it in a lot of artwork I've done. I've stuck little bits of it in Slap and the comics I do and on the skateboards I did for Think, and like I'll just try and like put it out there, and I don't really try and project it as anything. You know, it's more about that fascination of making something out of nothing. I have friends that travel around the world for skateboarding or for art or whatever else. They're like, I was in South Africa, dude, I saw an SPB sticker. I was in fucking Paris. They were all over the place. I had a friend just get back from Tokyo, and he's like, dude, every skate park I went to in Tokyo had SPB stickers up at it. And I guarantee it wasn't any of the 8 kids I grew up with. So it's gotten to the point where it's evolved so much in its own locations that there's guys that make t-shirts for it that don't even know who I am. ever consider myself a graffiti artist or ever put myself in that category or try and project myself as one of those guys, but I definitely got into it. To me, like coming from where I lived in upstate New York, moving out to the Bay Area and just seeing this new type of graffiti, like graffiti to me was just New York. It was just bombing, it was just fill-ins and like piecing yards, and just it was very like textbook graffiti because it was New York, you know. It's like to move here and see all these people's like wild interpretations of what it had become on the West Coast and like all the character oriented stuff, which being like an illustrator was like way more like eye-catching to me and like grabbed me right away, you know. But I definitely messed with it for a few years. It's like there's so many millions of things I can go to do to fill my day here. It's just like, it's infinite. And I think that's really important to me at this point in my life. Like I think the influences of living in this city have changed the way I work like tenfold. You know what I mean? I think that's why there's so many artists that live here and always have been. And San Francisco is just such a visually intense city, both architecturally and in terms of the like people that live here, that between people watching and just like admiring the city's like physical beauty is just like, that's enough to keep me busy for years, you know what I mean? Come.